Oh, you're home. Rose, Rachel's home. And she brought her new friend.
Our surprise star returns. You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
Nailed it. I must have been pretty memorable.
You were. I get the sense that you're used to making an impression.
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must?
I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Thanks, but I was just gonna stop in for a sec and then bounce.
Oh, did you have other dinner plans?
Dinner plans? I always thought dinner was something that just sort of happens.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
Okay, I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
Just hurry back. I don't know how long I can keep this up.
Try doing it your whole life. And, Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know...
that I would normally say.
Exactly.
Just some quality time with the Ambers. What could possibly go wrong? Like a thousand times more skeevy when the skeeviness is all polite to your face. Hiya, Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
So, you're a district attorney, huh?
I'm your district attorney.
So I can call you if I'm ever district arrested?
What would you be arrested for?
It was a joke. Not a good one, clearly. What do you think? I thought Rachel was perfectly cast.
She certainly was. We're very proud of her. I had no idea they were going to do that.
Do what?
I don't know the name for it. Reverse casting? Casting a woman as a man?
Oh. I just meant the wizard part.
I suppose that's also true.
Your daughter's pretty great.
Thank you. We're fond of her as well.
You ever feel like she's so awesome at everything that you just want to shake her? Yeah. Me neither. Duty calls. Hey. Good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Rachel really was an overachiever before she met me. Glad I nipped that in the bud. Rachel and I both had great childhoods. Mine just ended a little before hers, I guess. What the Amber family considers entertainment looks a lot like what I consider homework. Solved it. Something about this photo doesn't seem right. I should fix it. Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is right there. She totally bust me. Hi, Rose. Your husband's cheating on you. Pass the ketchup. Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight.
What did you think of the play?
Rachel was typically amazing, but I never liked The Tempest. What did you think of it?
To be honest, I only really read a couple pages. Theater's not really my thing. I guess I'm not so into saying words someone else came up with.
Fair point. Then again, I'm not sure you can judge the entire art form based on the dead white men your curriculum focuses on.
Damn. Shots fired, Shakespeare. So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight.
She sure was. And I imagine whatever trick the two of you pulled to get her back on stage was even more dramatic than the play.
We can be very persuasive together.
Persuasive. Yes, that's a word for it. I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well.
You can? Because it still seems crazy to me. Integrity, honesty, loyalty.
What?
It's on your lawn.
Oh, right. Sorry. I guess I'm still getting used to being an elected official's wife.
What's it like being married to the DA?
Much like being married to anyone else, I imagine.
But with a lot more secrets, right?
Secrets?
Like attorney-client privilege and all that.
Well, as district attorney, he brings cases against criminals on behalf of the state. He doesn't defend them.
Of course not. So, you putting me to work or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
You're a riot, Chloe.
All right, Chloe, you've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before. Piece of cake. No skeletons. Lots of shiny dishes, though. Off to the table with you. Oh, I think that's an original Who Gives a Shit. I bet there's, like, not even a single Cheeto stuck in this thing. Holy shit. That's the guy who attacked Drew, and I'm holding on to a grand of his money. Rachel and I couldn't be leaving town soon enough. Doing the play was bad enough without having to read about it afterwards. Hope Drew's okay, though. How to clear browser history, followed by a gap for all of yesterday? That's like cheating asshat 101. Poor Rachel.
Yes, Chloe?
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine. They say all news is local, but damn.
Something else?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Okay. One, two, three, sherry.
Comical. Chloe, maybe you can help me understand something.
I'll give it a shot.
Rose and I, we're worried about Rachel. Yesterday was so unlike her. What do you suppose is going on?
Besides all my bad behavior rubbing off on her, you mean?
Another joke.
You tell me. It seemed like you and Wells were happy to believe that this morning.
And you were all too eager to play into our expectations. In my experience, that's a tactic people use to cover for someone else. Rachel is her own person. She's responsible for her actions. I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
Thanks.
Yes, Chloe?
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding. It's the fancy-looking cabinet, right?
You got it.
Glasses. Damn. The Ambers are fancy as shit.
It's the triangle-shaped one.
Basic shapes. Now you're speaking my language.
Yes, Chloe?
What else? Feel like I'm getting good at this.
Only one last step. As our guest, you may do the honor of lighting the candles. The lighter is in the-
It's cool. I've got my own.
Oh.
You never know when you'll need to light a candle. Right?
You are a paragon of preparedness.
Thanks. I think. Time to light some candles and bless this joint up a bit. The Amber family and fire. What could possibly go wrong?
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
Not since this morning.
Oh, gosh. I'm so sorry.
Nah. That's cool. We're not.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me. 'Cause you're the DA, of course.
It's certainly troubling. The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Well said, dear. It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us. Family. Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Enough of this asshole. Rachel may have to take it, but I don't. I'm going to turn his daughter and wife against him at his own dinner table. I'm not sure I agree, James.
Oh? I thought you of all people would be grateful for family, at least.
If you ask me, gratitude is just one more way privileged people tell the unprivileged that they should be happy with what they have.
That is an excellent point, Chloe. We must always be sensitive to the way our privileges shape our perspectives.
Well said, Mom.
Still, there must be some room for personal responsibility. I'm sure you agree, Chloe.
My dad was super responsible. He always drove under the speed limit, Then one day, a truck came along and turned him into a super responsible pancake.
See? This is why it's so important to invite diverse voices to converse with one another. It's absolutely stimulating.
Highly stimulating.
Since you have answers for everything, Chloe, perhaps you'd like to enlighten us with some of your hard-earned wisdom about the world.
Sure. I believe that we should look closely at everyone, especially the people in power, to see what secrets they're hiding.
Very well articulated, Chloe. I am consistently impressed with how politically aware your generation is.
Chloe is an excellent articulator.
Excuse me, dear? But if this is what passes for politically aware these days, we're in serious trouble.
James, that's unfair and also rude to Chloe.
No, I don't believe it is. It seems clear that these points Chloe is making are merely veiled attacks on me.
Are you suggesting that I'm using some sort of incognito mode where I can keep my activities hidden? That's crazy. Don't worry, Mr. Amber. I can tell that my progressive attitude is not welcome in this house. I'll see myself out.
James, Chloe is right. You owe her an apology.
I owe her no such thing. I believe she's willfully acting belligerently, just as she did this morning. It is how people like her respond to adversity.
People like her? So we're profiling now? This is what 8 months in the DA's office has taught you.
I resent that. My office is committed to fair and equitable treatment.
Yes, I've read the press releases.
Excuse me? Are you calling me a hypocrite?
Ha!
Rachel!
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad! You're a hypocrite! Okay? I know! You lying, cheating, piece of shit, motherfucker.
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Rachel, honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
No offense, Mr. Amber. But I think we trust our eyes more than you.
That's enough! You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of you.
Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to her like this.
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Shadows settle on the place that you left. Our minds are troubled by the emptiness. Destroy the middle, it's a waste of time. From the perfect start to the finish line. And if you're still breathing, you're the lucky ones. cause most of us are heaving through corrupted lungs, setting fire to our insides for fun, collecting names of the lovers that went wrong, the lovers that went wrong. Most of us are bitter over someone, setting fire to our insides.